stretch out on the end of that lead that he had on yesterday. And now it's shrunk back up.
You're in this corner, Dottie.
Oh, it'll be mostly in the player's face here.
Jordan Spieth got a huge break here. He caught the trees on the corner and then popped back into the fairway.
They've taken away the second cut down the left, so if you do hit a hook down there, there's not much to stop it.
Signaling left. Oh, yes. That did get very lucky. That is way down.
His mark was down there.
That's a short to mid iron for the second.
Go in tree trouble.
At three. We have 30 yards.
Yeah, I wanted to leap in there, Frank, to say that. Probably was too close.
Yeah, I agree with you, Nick, but yeah. Did the right thing, a little over the back. It's better than being short. To the second.
And to Dickie with the driver this time. It was the 3 wood off the first that went way right.
His misses on the range, going upward to the right. He was most happy with just that touch of a draw.
He only hit 5 fairways yesterday. Leads the field in scrambling. That's how you do it. 320 past that bunker you just saw. But he'll be a long way short of Xander's, who really bounded off the hill. The weight of a nation. Masao Aoki ran second in the US Open to Jack Nicklaus back in 1980. That's the best finish by a Japanese player. Now Justin Rose. Make up for that bogey at the first. Justin Rose, 2 second place finishes here at the Masters. Can he make amends with another fine round today like he did on Thursday? Matsuyama leads by 1 here in the 85th Masters.
one right here. It is Caddy, Scott Twight. They're just trying to pick out a general area to putt to and then let gravity take over.
And Billy, this, the portion of the golf course where you just need to hold on.
Up the hill.
This is a putt that he hit a lot of in his pre-round practice session, and just working on speed, kind of feeding it around the hole. But it was this shape, this distance.
Yes, it's one of the weeks of the year that all the players will practice their putting for an hour a day more than they normally would. Try and get used to the amount of break on these extremely fast greens. Just trying to lag it up there when they get this quick. Throw it out to the right and let it fall down. Just like this.
No stress, huh?
Very nice. I like the fact too, Dottie, that he keeps that putt ahead moving. He's not staying static. I like that.
He's gotten himself into a very comfortable, as you said, level position, and then it flows beautifully.
Two hardest holes on the course to now at 5 and 10. He's parred them both. Over to 12.
Mine's not too bad for speed and going uphill. Just plays that little stab shot so beautifully. Not that far away. It's the 11th green. This one downhill, 5.5 feet. Spieth to tap in at 12. That's an excellent forward 11. Nice to see some color there on the hill at 12, and the applause. Blast of color here in Amen Corner.
Can be aggressive up the hill. Oh, how good were those two putts to not go in? So 8 holes to play. Matsuyama leads Zalatoris by 5. Let's check in with Amanda Baliotis.
Here with John Rahm. John, yesterday, in one word, you described your round as frustrating. After a final round 66, how'd you describe today?
Satisfying. That's all I can say, right? I think if anybody was watching and they go back on the highlights, you can hear me numerous times. When I hit a shot right at the pin, and just from the frustrations of the first few days, not getting the wind right, I'm like, get lucky. Just be the right one. The cases of 4, 6, 12, I'm just looking at it like, let's just hope we got the win right this time, because we had good shots, and today it happened, made a few putts, and posted a great score.
This is looking like it's going to be your fourth consecutive top 10 here at the Masters. When you look at your record here, is it now a matter of not if, but when you put on the green jacket?
Hope so. You know, it's one of those things where it kind of sounds